In this video, we focus on a DC-DC type of power electronic interfaces that facilitate the conversion from one DC voltage level to another DC voltage level. The main learning objective will fall on the three main questions. Firstly, what is duty cycle? Secondly, what is the ratio between the input voltage and output voltage of a DC-DC buck converter? And thirdly, what are the operating states of buck converters? We show here the schematic representation of a real and a real photo of a switch. As an example, we show an insulated gate bipolar transistor IGBT switch. These power electronic switches are able to turn on and turn off with the switching frequency from hundreds of hertz up to hundreds of kilohertz. In other words, they are able to turn on and turn off within a half a microsecond. The new silicon carbide and gallium nitride based switches turn on and off even faster, within tens of nanoseconds. In this particular IGBT switch, an anti-parallel diode is included that allows the reverse currents. The converter is the main responsible for stepping up or down the input voltage, Vin, to a desired level of voltage at the output, V output. The input DC source can be, for instance, a battery or photovoltaic solar array. The output can be connected to the DC link with a standard voltage. Based on the input and output voltage ratio, we recognize the buck or step down converter, where the output voltage is always lower than the input voltage. The other converter is stepping up the voltage, that is the boost converter. In this video, we will discuss only the buck converter, and in the next video, we address the boost converter as well as combination of both converters. Let's have a look at one of the simplest forms of the DC voltage conversion, that is a buck converter or step-down chopper. In the figure, we show the circuit diagram of a simplified buck converter, which includes only one switch and a diode with an inductor. The inductor is the main responsible for smoothing out the output current. In the figure, we show the output voltage of the converter versus time. We define T on as the on time of the switch, whereas T is the total time of a period. If the switch is on, then the output voltage is equal to the input voltage. And if the switch is off, then the output voltage is equal to zero. The output voltage is changing between two values, Vin and zero, and thus has a very large ripple. As we can see in this figure, the average output voltage, V output average, in the dotted blue line, depend on the ratio of on time of the switch and the total period. The diode is called freewheeling diode, which takes over the load current in the interval when the switch is off. The circuit diagram of the buck converter step-down chopper can be completed by adding a parallel resistor, which represents the amount of the load consumption. If we add a capacitor in parallel with the resistor, we will help reduce the voltage ripple as it can be seen in the figure. As we increase the value of the capacitor, the amount of the voltage ripple is further reduced. In the previous slides, we mentioned that the capacitor helps reduce the output voltage ripple. Indeed, the capacitor suppresses the rate of the change of the output voltage, which is reflected as the current of the capacitor. This is mainly due to the fact that the capacitor is able to maintain the voltage to some extent by absorbing or releasing its stored energy, E, which depends on the capacitances and on the square of the DC voltage across the capacitor. While the capacitor is used in parallel to maintain the level of DC voltage, an inductor can be employed in series to maintain the level of DC current. The inductor is smoothing out the rate of the change of the current that is reflected as the voltage across the inductor. Similarly, the inductor is able to release or absorb its stored energy, which depends on the inductance and on the square of the current passing through the inductor. There are different ways to chop the DC voltage. In pulse width modulation method, or PWM method, as we call it, the total time period of the signal is fixed, and then the on time of the switch is changed. This method is effective when the fundamental switching frequency has to be constant. In the frequency modulation method, unlike the PWM modulation method, the The on time of the switch remains constant and the total period changes. This method is used when the variable switching frequency is needed. The graph shows the time intervals T on and T off during which a switch turns on and turns off over a complete switching cycle respectively. The duty cycle is defined as the ratio of on time period divided by the complete switching cycle. The value of duty cycle ranges from 0 to 1. As we introduced before, the step down or the so-called buck converters are widely used to reduce the level of the input voltage. The output voltage of a buck converter is calculated by the input voltage multiplied by the previously introduced duty cycle, D. We can consider two states of operation for the buck converter. In the first operating state, the input source is connected to the output where it stores some energy in the inductor. Note that the voltage of the inductor, VL, is positive since the input voltage is larger than the output voltage. During the second state, the switch turns off and accordingly the input is disconnected from the inductor. During this state, the energy stored in the inductor is fed to the output. Let us now see how the current of the inductor changes during these two operating states as the inductor current is shown in the figure. During the first state, the current of the inductor increases where the current derivative depends on the difference of the input and output voltage. During the second operating state, the voltage across the inductor is equal to the minus of the output voltage. During this state, the inductor releases the stored energy to resistive load and the current derivative only depends on the output voltage. Let's see the voltage through the inductor during both on and off states of the switch. During one switching cycle, it is important to note that the average inductance voltage variation is equal to zero. This means that the green area during on period is equal to the red area during the off time, and as a result of the voltage of the inductor at the beginning and at the end of each cycle will remain the same. The average output voltage, V output average, is a product of the duty cycle and the input voltage. In this video, we introduce the duty cycle of one switch and focus on the most common DC power converters, the so-called buck or step-down chopper. We evaluated two operating states of the converter during on time and off time of the switch. During the next video, we will address the rest of the DC converters types like the boost converter and other converters.